Dear students, this is Dr. Anuradha Naik. I hope you have gone through my previous video. Today, I will present a lecture on St. Thomas Aquinas. St. Thomas Aquinas was a Roman political thinker who uplifted the lost glory of Christianity during his time. He was very much influenced by Aristotelian thoughts. To deal with his life, he was born in 1227 AD at a place called Sicily in Naples. Since childhood, he was very studious. He studied the theories of Aristotle under the guidance of Albert Magnus. Albert Magnus was a great follower of Aristotelian theories. For a couple of years, he studied at Paris, where he came across various popes and kings. He became a writer and also a teacher. He dedicated his entire life for the service of Christianity. He died at an early age of 47 in the year 1274 AD. His important works are, number one, Logica, which is his greatest work. It deals with nature and God. Secondly, Summa Contra Gentiles, which deals with Christianity and its basic principles. And his third work, De Regime Principum, which deals with social and political needs and necessities of man. His important points are in the form of his theories. Now, let us deal with his theories. The very first theory of him is the theory of classification of laws. Aquinas, in his work Summa Theologica, gives a description of laws. According to him, law is an order which is a result of knowledge and reason in the interest of public good. Law always cares for the interests of the public, and hence it has to be followed by the people. Laws are essential to regulate the people and to provide a moral background to their lives. Let us deal with his classification of laws. He classified laws mainly into four categories, such as, number one, eternal law. Eternal law is the base for all kinds of actions of human beings. It is formulated by the Almighty God. Human beings, animals, birds, and plants are the creatures of God. Hence, they are all controlled by eternal law, which is framed by God. Second, natural law. Created by nature. It is also a base for all the human actions. Because of this law, man recognizes difference between right and wrong, just and unjust actions. It regulates the human behavior. The third is divine law. This is a law which inspires individual to lead a spiritual life. It helps in realizing ultimate goal. Sometimes individuals commit mistakes in taking their decisions, but this law guides the individuals in taking proper decisions. Divine law is exhibited by the people who have imbibed divine qualities, such as the monks and the priests and the other religious leaders. The Old Testament and the laws originated after Jesus Christ belong to this category. Fourth category is human or man-made law. These are the laws formulated by rulers for the social well-being of the community. In monarchy, king is the supreme lawmaker. In democracy, legislature consisting of the representatives of the people is the lawmaking body. Now, come to the theory of state. According to Saint Aquinas, God has created the society along with the universe. Man is also a creation of God. Hence, in order to fulfill his needs, he lives in the society. He believes Aristotle's idea that the state has also originated in order to provide a life to the individuals, and it continues to exist in order to provide a better life to the individuals. State and government are created by the will of God, and hence their powers are also drawn by God. Just as human body is ruled by the soul, in the same way God, the government, rules the state. Its aim is to provide happiness to the people. The state, with the help of virtue, reason and knowledge, must look after the welfare of the people. Now, the functions of the state and government. He narrates the functions of the state and government in his book, De Regim Principum. These are, number one, developing virtues among the people. A virtuous state will always think of developing virtues among the people. Second, eradicating antisocial elements from the society. To achieve this purpose, proper laws are to be framed. Law abiders must be awarded and law violators must be punished severely so that people do not dare to violate the laws. Number three, basic necessities must be provided to all in sufficient quantity, proper distribution of goods. Number four, eradication of poverty and control of inflation. Number five, proper or adequate living wages must be provided to workers. Number six, proper weighing measures, weight and measure system should be followed in the state. Number seven, proper education and training towards cultivating virtues among the people. Number eight, protection of state from internal disturbances and external attacks. Now, let us move to the next theory, that is classification of governments. As he was influenced by Aristotle, he accepted Aristotelian classification of governments as well. The constitution or governments must be classified into pure and corrupt forms. He found three pure forms and three corrupt or perverted forms. The three pure forms are monarchy, aristocracy and polity. The three impure forms are tyranny, oligarchy and democracy. According to Aristotle, polity is the best form of government. But according to Aquinas, monarchy is the best. For that he gives his own reasons. If a single person rules, He can bring about unity and stability. He can take decisions quickly and can control the people. But to achieve this purpose, the king should be virtuous. These are the three theories advocated by Aquinas. With this, let us conclude. Thank you.